All right, so it's been a crazy few days since Line 6 dropped the 3.0 firmware update for all of its Helix products, and since you clicked on this video, I'm sure you've already heard about it. One huge update the HX Stomp users like myself got was not only the addition of 2 extra blocks, now we have 8 blocks, we got some really cool effects, we got some new amps and CAS, but now we have access to Command Center. Helix users already had it, but now we got it, and that's what we're going to be talking about today, and specifically, how you can become a MIDI pro using Command Center with your HX Stomp. Not only are we going to talk about it, but I'm actually going to show you. I noticed that there's not a lot of videos walking you step by step showing you exactly how to use this. So I really want to prioritize that today for this video, so that's what we're going to do. So let me read you something real quick from the Line 6 update page. It says this: why would people expect a stomp box with only 3 foot switches to also act as a master MIDI controller? Yeah, we don't know either, but enough of you asked for it and it wasn't exceedingly difficult to add. Yeah, it might seem like overkill for such a small unit, but I think it's gonna really help a lot of people get into the world of MIDI. Now, like I said, we're gonna be talking about MIDI. Now, Command Center can do a bunch of different things. I haven't even wrapped my head around it all of it yet. I actually saw Alec Bourne from the MIDI Mad Scientist Club say, like, trying to explain what you could do with Command Center would be like trying to explain all the individual sides of a circle. And what he meant was the possibilities are endless with this. If you haven't subscribed to his channel and you want to discuss all the philosophical implications of what all these new toys means for you, I would definitely go subscribe to his channel. But quick question, what are some of the things that you want to control with Command Center? It can do a bunch of different things. Let me know down in the comments and maybe I can make a video about that as well. But today we're gonna be focusing on controlling external MIDI pedals via Command Center. Now, if you've been around the channel at all, you know that over the last few months, I've gotten into the world of MIDI for the first time, and my MIDI controller of choice has been the Jet Pedal Stuff. I started off with the Jet Micro, and now I have the Jet MCX. But the big question I've been hearing, and I've really been wondering myself, is will we still need external MIDI controllers once the HX Stomp gets Command Center? And the short answer for me is maybe not. You might not need an external MIDI controller. Did I say mini or MIDI? MIDI controller. And that's what I wanted to help you out with today, is how can Command Center help you dive into the world of MIDI? Now, I'll say up front, I'm not gonna be getting rid of my MCX. There's just too many options I have with this thing. After exploring Command Center, this thing just still offers way more options than what Command Center is going to be able to offer. And this would be true too if you have any of the other MIDI controllers, like the Morningstar devices, or even like the new one that's coming out soon. I think it was called a Pirate MIDI. That thing looked really awesome. But I say that as someone who already has a MIDI controller. I've already purchased it. I've already bought into it. But maybe some of you are out there wanting to tiptoe your way into the world of MIDI and you don't know if you want to pull the trigger on spending money on a MIDI controller just yet. Command Center is perfect for you. Now, although Command Center is a little bit limiting when it comes to sending MIDI messages to external MIDI pedals, I think there's a really good scenario that would help you to get started, and that is to run your stomp in snapshot mode. Now, there's pros and cons to this. Let's talk about the cons first. The con is that being a snapshot mode, you won't be able to have individual access to stomp pedals. You won't be in stomp mode at all, and that may not be a big deal to you. And the only other con is that you won't be able to scroll up and down through presets without bending over and adjusting this top knob. But let's say you're good with all of that, then what are the pros? What can you do? Well, now with Command Center, you can send up to 6 different MIDI CC messages per snapshot. That's a huge deal because in essence, now you could control up to 6 different MIDI pedals with the click of a switch. Or you could tell a couple pedals, like I have, to do several different things at once. So like on my board, I run the MIDI version of the Revelation by Jet Pedals and the MIDI version of the Broken Arrow by Jackson Audio. On snapshot 1, using these CC messages, I could tell each of these pedals to come on. Well, that's 2 messages. I have 4 messages left. Then in that same snapshot, I could choose the algorithm and the reverb and select the overdrive, which is just 2 more MIDI messages. So we have 2 left. So with the 2 left, I could then choose 1 parameter on each of these pedals to adjust. But that's just 1 snapshot. After that, snapshot 2 could tell the reverb to change algorithms and to bump up the decay and turn down the mix. And I could also bump up the gain on the Broken Arrow and also turn a boost on. And then I still have snapshot 3 to adjust those same parameters. And I can do all of that without an external MIDI controller. How cool is that? All right, so now let me actually show you how to do this. But I gotta say, I just rewired my board. If you saw the video a while back, I'll link it up here. I rewired my board, and then right after that, actually I'll link this video, this one's more important, I made a video called Intro to MIDI, and I show you exactly, step by step, how I use the web editor of the Jet MCX to send MIDI messages to the HX Stomp, my reverb, and my overdrive. And one of the things I explained in my video is that MIDI is a one-way street, and one of the things I did when I wired my board was, I am not set up to use Command Center right now because I am bypassing it. Right now, my MIDI signal flow leaves the Jet MCX, goes into a device under called the Disaster Area MIDI Box 4, and from there it goes to my three other pedals. But for me to be able to use Command Center, I would need to reroute that. I would need to leave the Jet MCX, go straight to the HX Stomp, go in and then through to that MIDI box to my other pedals. It's a little confusing, but I was trying to use Command Center earlier and I didn't realize why it wasn't working. It was like, oh yeah, I'm not actually sending from the Stomp to my other pedals. I'm just going straight from the MCX. And I'm not gonna rewire that right now. But let me show you, if it was wired right, what you would need to do. All right, so I have a blank preset here. And just for fun, let's see if we can fill up all 8 blocks. Let's pick an amp and cab and we'll use the new one. We'll use the US Princess. For fun, let's add some modulation. Let's see if we can do some stereo. Let's see how many stereo effects we can use. We'll use a chorus. Let's do a couple delays, some stereo delays. We'll do a simple delay. Then we'll do the stereo mod course echo. I really like that one. We'll do a, let's see, a stereo, no, the legacy plate. I like doing that. And then we'll do a stereo glitz. Okay, we're still good there. Let's do an overdrive, distortion. Let's do the Timmy. And then let's see if we can got one more. What do we have room for? Dynamics, EQ, compressor, stereo. We don't have room for a compressor. Let's see, EQ, stereo, EQ. Yeah, simple EQ. We could boost some stuff here. All right, we're not gonna see what it sounds like because that's not the point of this video. But what is the point of this video is that we need to figure out how to use Command Center to control through these snapshots, control my other pedals. So I'm going to save my progress. Now to find Command Center, you go up here to Window, and you go to Command Center. Now right here, we have all these instant commands, which is what we're gonna be doing today. And then you also have foot switches 1 through 3 and 4 and 5 if you're using an external foot switch. And you can also use up to 2 expression pedals to do this same sort of thing. All right, so we're gonna use, like I said, we're gonna use one of these instant things. I'm gonna click on it. And in snapshot one, let's say I want to turn on my overdrive pedal and my reverb pedal, like I said earlier. So I'm gonna go to MIDI CC because I wanna send a MIDI control change message. And now we need to know some stuff. Now, if you saw my other video, you know that you would need to have your device's manuals handy so you can see what it takes to turn on and off your devices. Now I have my broken arrow right here. To turn it on and off, I need a CC message of 1 and a value of 127 or 0 to turn it back off. So we're gonna do CC message 1, a value of 127. For the Revelation reverb, I need a CC message of 23 with a value of 0 to turn it off or 127 to turn it on. So let's try that. All right, I'm here, I'm gonna send a MIDI CC message. The channel is which channel your device is on. I explained that in the other video, go check that out. I know that my overdrive is channel 3 and I wanna send a CC message of 1, we said, and I want it to come on, so we're gonna max it out. All right, so that's 1 of the 6. I'm also gonna do another one here. Let's do a CC message, send it to channel 2, which is my reverb. It was a CC message of 23. And I want it to turn on. Now, if my board was wired up, let's save that. When I go from my different snapshots, snapshot 2, back to snapshot 1, it just sent a MIDI message over to these two pedals. Now, they didn't physically come on because, like I said, it's not wired up right, but that's how easy it is. All right, so let's take it a step further. Let's say I wanted to do, I'm gonna fill up the other 4 commands. I want them not only to turn on, but I want them to do something specific. So let's go to this one, my overdrive. I want to not only tell it to come on, but what do I wanna do? Let's pull up the manual again. I wanna choose gain cycle, which is a CC of 4. And a value of 1, let's just do 25%. CC message going to my broken arrow, CC number of 4, and a value of 1, which was our lowest gain stage. All right, let's save that. I always like to save things in case something happens. Just get in the habit of saving stuff. All right, so let's do something on the Jet Revelation. Let's say I want the mix knob to be at noon. So we wanna send a CC message of 20 to the reverb pedal at a value of 64. Let's do it. CC message to the reverb, CC number of 20 at a value of 64. Now this is straight up noon, but if I wanna increase the mix, I could go all the way up. This is 100% mix, this is no mix. So we'll just be right here in the middle. And there, we have it. Now we still have two more things we could do. But I don't wanna waste your time, I want you to go try it. I know you got this. After watching this video, you can just follow these steps and send those MIDI messages to your pedals. And if you want a crash course in intro to MIDI, like I said, I made that video, I'll link it below, go check that out as well. Now like I said earlier, the con is that you still only have three switches. So if you're gonna be in snapshot mode, you can't really control the stomp to do anything else without bending over. And so if you're not gonna get an external MIDI controller, which is still the better option, because with the press of a button, I can control the different snapshots. As you can see, I'm controlling snapshot 1, 2, 3 right there. I can also press AB or BC to scroll up and down through presets. I can leave my stomp in stomp mode and still click on and off different things. And with a long press, I can still access my tuner. So that's definitely a way to go. But if you don't want to shell out the money for that, you could spend, what, the $25 and get the Moleski 2-switch, foot switch, pedal thingy, whatever it's called. I still have one up in my office. If you use your stomp in snapshot mode, you could set up that external foot switch to scroll up and down presets, and maybe that's all you would need. Either way, I hope this video was helpful for you to spark some creativity, to give you some ideas on what you could use this Command Center update for. If you like this video, I'm gonna ask you to do something no YouTuber has ever done before, and that is to like and subscribe to my channel. Like this video if you actually did like it and you want more content like this. Also subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on anything new when it does come out. Also, if you haven't heard, I got some really good deals going on right now for Black Friday. I have a digital worship planner. If you're into that, go check that out. And I also have my HX Stomp preset pack called my Expanse Pack. You buy it one time, you get updates for free for life. Definitely go check that out. That's all I got today. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.